Hey everyone, it's Apache here and welcome back to Sebtech Ages here on the Creecraft server. Thank you for joining me today and continuing to show your support for the series. If you do enjoy this episode, please leave a like and a comment, and if you're new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe as well. I'm here today with Nathan, as you can see here, and hopefully, hopefully he's going to give us a tour around the server today and show us what's been going on.
Yeah, we've been talking for a little bit, been kind of getting some ideas on where Apache can settle his base, and so we may go over a little of that later too. But so, yep, we are here in my, I call this the Buffalo Plains, but I don't think I've referred to that in a video yet, but I have very, very affectionately referred to this as the Buffalo Plains for obvious reasons. Yeah. So, yeah, this is my area. Obviously, I have my massive wheat, cotton, carrot, and potato farms over here. And those are going to continue to grow. And so I am really looking forward to seeing what that looks like, especially from the air after that is all completed.
Yeah, we saw those a couple of episodes back when we came through here, going through all the other wheat farms over there. We did that on a small scale in Beyond, a very, very, very small scale, towards the end of Beyond. But it's been taken to a whole new level here.
Yeah, and I've still got a lot of wheat to plant over there, but there's a lot of terraforming to be done here now because I am adding so many new buildings to the area. My original stream that I put in here is no longer functional because it interfered with the building, and there's this massive cave here. Be careful with that. It might kill your horse.
Yeah,
it's a long ways down. But so, yeah, we want to be really careful with that. But I've got my warehouse, and I really like the way that it turned out. This is a slightly different style build for me, and I really like it. More than anything, it's the roof that is really different on this one. And it was one heck of a challenge to get that to work. And then, of course, we've got the blacksmith, and then further down the path, we've got the mill. And there's going to be a lot more buildings coming in the next few episodes, so definitely look forward to that.
That's good. One thing I can't wait for in here in the storage room is to see how you're going to fit all of the external storage cables for AE into this.
Somehow I will try to figure it out, but that is a long way down the road. So.
Oh, I know. It's I can just imagine it, just cables all over the place in there.
It's gonna have to be underneath, and there's gonna have to be some that I just can't reach, and that's just the way that it's gonna be.
Yeah, it's kind of a shame because I know you've said you're gonna be kind of updating your buildings as you go through, upgrading them.
Yeah,
I think it's almost a little bit of a shame in some ways, but the only place that this in the end will be remembered is within your episodes. But won't actually be exactly like this on the server anymore with the chests and stuff with storage.
Yeah, I know. And I've given that some thought, but you know, it shows that, sometimes you just have to let go of some things. You know, we have ideas, we have hopes, we have dreams, and sometimes you just got to let them go and kind of roll with punches and do what needs to be done to continue on with life. So I think it's a good lesson for everyone, too.
Wow, that's deep.
It is, isn't it? Weren't expecting that, were you?
No, I wasn't.
So, but, yeah.
Yes, I fully understand what you mean. It's an interesting way to do a Minecraft series, to actually be okay with letting go of buildings and completely and absolutely changing the structure of buildings whilst you're going along.
It's interesting. And I think we're going to have so much time with this mod pack because it is designed to be very long and drawn out. And so we're going to have so much time that I just feel that rather than trying to come up with new ideas and, you know, expanding just infinite directions and making huge things, I'm going to focus more on just trying to make my little spot be what I currently see it as being proper, you know, for my current advanced level and, you know, what I'm thinking, what I've been experiencing in life, and it will definitely show in the build. So I think it's a really nice idea.
Oh, that's good. I look forward to it.
So yep.
Let's just show my viewers around some of the insides of a couple of these ones. So you've got
there's
storage space in here, which is just full to the rafters in here.
And every one of these blocks is at least a chest worth of storage. So, I mean, the amount of storage here is ridiculous.
You have a lot of unfamiliar items.
I can imagine. And in the upstairs portion, I haven't even put anything up here. And so this will be able to have a huge amount of storage too. And I'm hoping to be able to kind of sort things out a little. And I may reduce the number of crates down here by a little bit, just to make it look a little less cluttered.
Yeah, do you know where anything is in here?
I know that I have flowers and dyes right here in this corner. I know I have wood products in this corner. This chest is mob drops. This crate is animal hides. And then these seven crates and chests are stone. Aside from that, I can't tell you a thing.
Right, okay. And I'm sure it'll all get moved around as well in the next...
Oh, yes. I'm gonna be trying to work on straightening it all out, getting it organized. One thing that I really thought was a cool idea is you're going to have obsolete items in this pack, and they're just going to pile up, and either you can throw them away or leave them in a chest. Well, one of the obsolete items is this cart. And so I figured I'll use the cart to store the obsolete items. And so it looks like a cart that is sitting here waiting to be unloaded at the warehouse. And I think that's just the perfect idea.
That's good. So, just having a look in the chest, see what is actually obsolete, but you know.
Yeah, and there's some of it, you know, like the Abyssal Craft stuff is not really obsolete to me, but... I don't have a use for it yet, so it's basically just taking up space.
And then in this building here...
So this is my blacksmith, and I need to work on getting a lot of interior work done here, but I really love the way this building turned out.
I was saying in my first episode, maybe second episode, about limestone and how underused limestone is as a block in modded. I really enjoy the textures of it, the stuff you can do with chisel. It's just so versatile.
Yep. And then of course got the tinkers set up out here, and I need to get this all reset up. I actually had originally a forge right here, just a show forge, and it was just too close to the smeltery, so I had to take it down, and I want to get that all set back up again.
Yeah.
Kind of make it feel more like it belongs.
I think once I've got myself settled somewhere, which is going to be more permanent, the tinkers is the first thing I'm going to be setting up. So I'm going to have my kind of... regular big furnace going.
Yep. And by the way, feel free if you want to have some of these mud bricks once you get to building. I've got tons of them available.
Oh, that's good. Is that the roof
I
tiles?
Think they, yeah, they look amazing.
They do
so
look good.
But so over here across this little bridge is my mill. And so this was the first building that I built in the area, and it looked amazing when it was built. And once I built the blacksmith, it looked so run down and plain. It was ridiculous to see the comparison. So I did try to spruce it up a little, but it's just got nothing on the other builds in the area.
It's kind of hidden away back here.
Yeah. And it's actually kind of the feel that I'm looking for here, because in a medieval town, the town would be very cramped. And so that's kind of the feel that I'm going for here. I want it to feel like, you know, you can't see the buildings unless you're right on them.
Yeah, we said the same really with Beyond, didn't we, as well?
I actually wasn't on the Beyond server, so I don't know.
You were on the Beyond server?
Oh, yeah, on the Beyond server. I'm sorry. I'm okay.
Yeah, we
wow.
Yeah. When we put all the paths in on that and we started getting the spawn town sorted.
We
walked through all the paths saying it would be, how nice it is to be able to walk through and have buildings on either side of the paths and not be able to see the rest of the town.
Well, and like this here, I've hardly got room to put some trees in. And so that's a... I think it's amazing to have it like that. I have been giving some thought to this path, though, and it's just too sharp. And so I am going to have to kind of rough it up a little, put in some path blocks and break out a lot of this chiseled cobble, make it look... It's just too pretty. If you know what I mean.
Yeah, I do. And I like what you've done here, though. And this is your starting place was the fossil.
Yep. And not too long from now, the fossil will be going bye-bye, unfortunately. And it's going to be a hard one to do because it's been here basically from day one. So, I mean, I found it right away and it provided me shelter in the middle of the night and I just kind of stayed there. And... You know, it's going to be sad to see it go, but at the same time, it has been memorialized in more than 25 episodes so far. And so I think we can safely let it go, and there's enough to go on from there.
I'll tell you what you should do with that, actually, is one thing I would love you to do with all of these buildings is before you take them down and change their purpose, do a schematica of them. Take a schematic of them with Schematica so that you can actually save them. And then you
That's a nice idea.
Yeah, and then if you wanted to, you can put them all in a creative server so that, and then you can put that creative server up for download once this world's done.
That is a great idea. I would have never thought of that. Thank you very much for that idea.
Yeah, so you can see my base through the ages. You could actually take this entire
base.
As it stands in age, what are you on? Wait, age one, age two?
I am coming close to the end of age two.
Yeah, so this would be end of age two. So you could save this entire lot and then rebuild it in creative, and that would be your age two world. And then, say, 1,000 blocks away in the creative world, you'd have your age three world.
That is a great idea. I like it. So that's really about it for my base. I mean, of course, I've got my blood magic stuff here, a little bit of abyssal craft stuff. Nothing really to look at here. There's nothing there. Clear over by the mountain over there is the astral sorcery stuff. Not really much to look at there either.
It's about to be the pyramid type thing in it, the altar.
Yes.
Yeah.
I have built a lot of stuff in the Between Lands, but I think you probably want to wait to go there when you're ready to go there.
Yes, yeah. I really haven't watched much of your stuff on that, because I know the Twilight Forest is something I've been looking forward to go to for a while.
I haven't done anything with the Twilight Forest for so long that it's totally new to me. I mean, the last time I did the Twilight Forest was in like 1.6 or something like that. Oh, we got mobs.
Yeah, it's a bit of a death trap around here.
So this is Wandering One's place. He's been kind of trying to get some building done. He's usually not the overly big builder. He's usually more of a just pushing through the tech, make a big flat area and maybe a simple house. But he's trying a lot more this time around, and I really appreciate that. But so he's been leaving a lot of the existing terrain and trying to work with that. And I really like that. this is his astral sorcery pyramid. This thing is ridiculous.
I love it. And it's incredible.
It is very reminiscent to me of a like an Incan temple.
Yes, yeah, that's what I was thinking with it. The ziggurat.
But so, yep. And so then he's got his portals over there. He recently built the bridge over there. Prior to that, we always had to swim across the river here. That was never any fun.
And so this is going to be his blood magic altar, I assume.
Yep, that's his blood magic area. He's got the two abyssal craft areas, astral sorcery behind us, and then the between lands, twilight forest, the hunting dimension. And clear up there on top of that dirt pillar is his portal to the beneath. And the only way to get there, the only way to get there is via his climbing glove, which I don't have.
I suppose you could put a totem with spider climb on it.
But that only has a limited effect. Yes, and so you'd have to put multiples all the way up. And then you'd be able to climb all the way up.
Yeah.
But so he's got this bridge going across here and then a path going over there to his portals. And there's really not a lot to see over there. I mean, it's just basically the portals.
Yeah.
And so further down the path here, and we saw this in a live stream. It's been over a week ago now. But Wandering One and I finally got a bridge built across this little stream here. And then we built a big bridge here next to my Show Iron Mine.
Yes,
and
I love this iron mine. I saw you building this this bridge over here.
Nice. Yeah, and this is a nice bridge. It will fit even in later ages because, you know, we used the smooth stone slabs on the top, so it kind of has the feel of a more modern bridge. But at the same time, it has the wood and everything like that, so it has a feel of an older bridge.
Yeah.
And so
one thing I was thinking, if you come back over the other side of the bridge, I've been around here a bit, just looking around, and you've got this by the mine. You've got the path that comes up to the mine.
Yep.
Now down here, if you get off the horse, it's a bit easier to show.
Okay.
Down here would make a perfect little path down by the river. It feels so natural to walk down here.
Well, and then you could follow
the path round, and you could follow it down round to here. You could have something like a nice little secluded area back here somewhere.
Or even just a little boat dock.
Yeah.
That would be nice. Yeah.
I think if we didn't do something here, it would be a real shame.
It would, I agree. 100%. So yeah, that's definitely something we're going to have to look at. So, is my horse there for you?
No.
Oh, there it is.
Oh no, there he is. Excellent.
We had a problem with my horse
disappearing last episode, and we found it's a bug which happens occasionally with horses. They just disappear. If you relog, then they'll come back.
Or if someone else gets on your horse, they'll come back.
Yes, yeah, yeah. Other people can see them. They just de-render for you, basically.
It's not a great bug, but it's not a hard one to deal with. So that's kind of nice. Yep. Now, we do also have, if we were to follow the path out further, we have Primarin's base. Not really much to see there. I'm hoping that he'll come back here soon, but right now he's got a little bone house out there, and that's about it. So not a lot to see out that way.
Okay.
But that's basically it for the server tour. I mean, this is actually a bit different. You know, when I joined Creedcraft, you were the one to give me the tour.
Yes, yeah. And I've been away for a while because I've been doing loads of stuff in real life. And I've had a load of festivals to attend over the last couple of months. And so, yeah, I'm back now and I'm kind of raring to go, to be honest. So want to try and get as much content in as I can.
Yep. Well, what do you say we go take a look at the areas that we were thinking about for you?
Yes, that'll be good. So, well, seems like we're right over here. We'll cut away and we'll come back when we're over there.
Sounds like a great idea. All right, see you guys in a little bit. So we're over here on the west side of my base, and I've been slowly working a path out this direction, and it turns out there is a really nice spot right in line with this path where Apache is thinking might be a good place to build. So why don't we just head down that direction? We'll kind of get an idea of how far away it is from my base and where we actually have to go to get there. So you want to lead the way or should I?
I'll lead. When I first came up here looking for your base, following the path, I followed this path first. And so in my episode, we actually got up to here. And so my viewers have seen up to here already. But if we carry on through these woods and try and get through these trees, a little bit difficult at the moment, but that path will carry on through. We get to jungle, I suppose it is. Yeah. Jungle.
It's actually a swamp. It's a swamp. It's called a lush swamp.
Oh, nice. Okay. So yeah, we get to this swamp zone, and then if we carry on through the swamp zone, all the way to the coast, which is over here, we reach a cave on the left-hand side here, big kind of dugout cave, and a big waterfall, and there's another little cave there. But this isn't quite it. This is the back of where I'm looking at building. And if we carry on round to the west, I suppose it is here?
Yep, yeah. south and west.
Southwest. And around this big mountain here, we get to the real magic of it here. And so this is it. All of this.
And this is absolutely amazing. So much potential in this spot.
Yeah. I'm scared of this, to be honest. There's a lot here.
And you actually haven't seen it, but further around the mountain, we can't get there on horseback, but further around the mountain, and actually I can show it to you. If you want to bring your horse down to the coastline, I have a boat. And we can actually, both of us can hop into the boat, and I can show you the, I have yet to figure out how to run boats here. I think your horse will pretty much stay put, so that shouldn't be too much of an issue. Oh. The rafts don't break lily pads. So just a little bit further around the side of this is more of this cliff, and I cannot steer this thing. But we saw this, and we have a river going up into a cave. And that looks like it would be a fun place to build something.
It does. And then, it looks like an evil laboratory kind of thing.
And then around here, so some of this stuff is just absolutely amazing. You know, if you look up into this, you know, there's
underwater in F5 modes. But yeah, it looks stunning.
So like this here, just almost a sheer cliff. Just amazing, and then this single little ribbon of water coming down the cliff.
I think, yeah, that ribbon of water, when I actually build into that, because I'll be building into that cliff, so I can put an observation post out right there where that water source starts there, and turn it into a room behind that. And so you'll have
that
a big window looking out over all of this.
But so there is just, like I say, there is so much potential for this area. And we've kind of been talking about the slow pace in this pack, and it is designed for longevity. So I don't think you'll be lacking in the amount of time that is needed to be able to build things here either.
Ooh. That's good. I've got about 150 different ideas of what to build. and probably about 6 or 7 different build styles to do them in as well. So,
yep. Yeah, there's so much opportunity, and you know, everyone always says there's no way to do it wrong. There's no way to build or to play in Minecraft wrong. So,
oh, I challenge accepted.
You're gonna find a way to do it wrong, huh?
Diamond blocks are building blocks, yeah?
Yeah, absolutely.
Gold blocks for roofing?
Yep, and emerald blocks for paths, right?
Yes, yeah, definitely, yeah.
Yep. That sounds like the perfect building palette. And make sure that the builds are just perfect rectangles, you know, no depth, no roofs, nothing like that. Just make it a nice big box.
Yep.
I know you better than that. You're not going to build like that.
If I had enough diamonds, I might. But
so
does this have an environmental tech in this pack?
I do believe it does, actually. So
eventually I will have enough diamonds to build with them then.
And actually, I know that it does, because there are some items that can only be gotten through the Void Ore Miner. So, I know it's in here. So, it may be a long time before we get to that point, but yeah. It is there.
Considering so I can't there was... even build a chest, then yes.
Oh, it'll get there. Anyway, so one thing that I did forget to show you, and it's just a little bit away from here, is this one fossil that I found, and I dug it all out by hand with just a regular stone pickaxe. And so I actually had thought about making this like a museum. And I thought it was kind of a neat idea, but it's close enough to your area that maybe you could do something with it.
Possibly, yeah. I mean, I quite like the idea of like an archaeological dig.
Yeah. And that was kind of the thought, and that's why I made sure that I did not disturb any of the bone blocks. I very carefully dug everything around it and left all the bone blocks exactly where they were. So there's a little idea, something that you can do when you have no thoughts on other things to do.
I mean, I'm going to be busy for a while, though, aren't I?
Yeah. I know I haven't run out of ideas. My biggest fear is that I'm not going to be able to get all my buildings built before I advance to the next stage. So I'm actually taking a little time away from tech to do some building. Kind of important.
That's a good idea.
So.
I want to focus on building quite a lot this season. I did a lot of tech stuff last season on Beyond and on Hermit Pack as well. So I want to focus more on the aesthetics and making sure all the surroundings are nice and neat as well. And try and not touch the land too much around me. I'll clear out a bit for space to build, but other than that, I want to try and keep the landscape as natural as I can.
Yep. And anytime that you can kind of terraform the land to make it look natural, even though you've changed it, that is a bonus too.
Yes. So yeah. There's some of the stuff with Minecraft terrain generation, even though it's much better in this pack than it is in vanilla. But even with this, there's some bits of the vanilla generation that leak through. That will need to be patched, like the impossible overhangs on mountains and stuff.
Yep.
That will need to be carved out. But other than that, it seems to be really quite nice. So it's going to be interesting to work with. But yeah, I'm looking forward to it.
Yep, it's not quite the alternate terrain generation, but it is close. So, I mean, it's really a nice looking world, and obviously we have lots of ravines and caves that we need to fill in, and that's always an issue in Minecraft. So yeah, that's the type of things we got to deal with.
Yep.
But hey, I think we're running out of time here, so.
Yes, yeah, we're just looking at the time on the video. Yes, we are.
So, I'm going to have to say thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, be sure to give a thumbs up. Be sure to check out Apache. Go see what he's been up to. For those that are watching Apache, go ahead, come over, take a look. I'll give myself a shameless plug. All right. So, yep. Guys, have any thoughts about what you'd like to see me or Apache be working on, or any thoughts for other collab builds? That would be great. But thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye.
If you enjoyed this video, please consider supporting me by subscribing to the channel and liking and commenting on the videos. Thanks. See you next time.